We're ready to go back. Sorry for not being Mary Kelly all night. We'll be right back. right here on when we played New Year's Eve in like 2000 and something. What fucking year was that? 2009, 2010? I was dressed up like Amy Winehouse on Bowling Planes wearing this purple party dress. And it was the first show I played sober. And I fucking rollerbladed right off the stage. And I couldn't believe it, I was sober. But you can watch it on YouTube, it's pretty funny. Because I ended up doing a flip over the monitor. And I kept the microphone in my hand and I yelled, like, do the flip! Yeah, that happened right here. That's why I'm close to it. I'm like, keep kind of moving shit back. I don't know if you're watching what I play. I'm like, no, not again, not in front of all these people. Great way to ring in the week. That would be an awesome way to finish the week. Throw it up, shitting your pants, falling off stage, completely sober. My life's a mess. This is an old song to the first record it's called Girl in My Life. Record again. This one's about having a really terrible year, and it's called having a drunk buffer of a year. So I hope you guys like it. It's got an ultimate Warped Tour 2005 ending. And I'm not going to be on Warped Tour this year because fuck that. Give me a break. Can you imagine being 42 years old on Warped Tour playing? It's just a lawsuit waiting to happen. 19-year-old kids walking around fucking almost naked, and it's like, and all I'm trying to do is like, not look at anybody. Like, but anyways, this is our call before we end.
Thank you.
guys ever heard of either, a record out called Songs Not to Get Married To? It's still my ex-wife called me and said, did you put a record out called Songs to Not Get Married To? No. Houston did this amazing thing at the Kid of Kids farewell show in Kansas City. I just gave her the house in Kansas City, so at the show I said, anybody that came from out of town that needs a place to stay, go to 4239 Genesee Street. And if a girl, blonde girl tattoos against the door and doesn't know what she's talking about, just push her out of the way and tell her it's cool. And at like 4:30 in the morning, she was like, can you tell a bunch of people at the show that they could come stay at my house? I don't know what you're talking about. I don't even know why I answered the phone. I know why. I was drunk. I wanted to see if it worked, and it did. But this is a song off that. It's called Take Me Home, Please.
Wawa or sheets?
Wawa!
Really? Do you think people on the Western part of the state would say sheets? I mean, it's like, fuck them! What's the better part of Pennsylvania? The East Coast? The South Coast? Well, I like Philly better, personally. I almost lived here. I was real close. Super close to living up, probably right around here, too. So I'm kind of glad I didn't, because I'd probably be dead. Anyways, we're going to play another song on the new record. We only have two left, and then Tinted Spittle's going to come up. I think on the 2003 tour, when Tinted Spittle and Reggie were on tour with Mike Kemp in Midtown, I think we played here. Or I know we played the Trop, but that's how long we've been friends, so it's really good to be back on tour with them. Now that everybody's so much fucking older, and I've been divorced twice, and like, life has just happened, but the music sounds exactly the same. But anyways, this song's about my mom passing away and watching my dad go through, like, just knowing that, like, we knew she was going to die for about a year, and just watching my dad, like, be very, very strong through the whole thing and not, like, the knowing that he's going to lose his partner for 46 years. And he held it together very, very well. My mom asked me before she died to write him a song. So this is that song. I'm real happy to play it for you. I hope you guys like it. It's called Magic. We'll be right back. Then one more song for you, the Loch Ness Monster getting divorced. I'll be at the merch table around here, John. You want to come over and buy shit? I'm going to sign it and take a picture. I'll be there. The reply leaned in there, he said, just go because I don't want to throw up again. Not in a big deal. I'll throw up in a van or a hotel or my house. But anyways, thank you guys so much. Since the scale's up next, we'll be right here.